Hi, I'm Cole from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll introduce you to Mailchimp Transactional Email. This is a powerful delivery service that helps you email customers about their purchases and account activity. If you have an online store, use this for order confirmations, shipping notifications, and password requests. Before we get started, here are some important things to know. Mailchimp Transactional Email is a paid add-on that's available on standard plans or higher. But to access the transactional email page, you'll need to have owner or admin level permissions. Sometimes you'll notice references to Mandrill. Mandrill is the same thing as Mailchimp Transactional. It does take some API or SMTP knowledge to send transactional email, and designing the content requires some understanding of HTML. So, reach out to your developer or check out our developer documentation. Lastly, if you want to send bulk messages like newsletters, transactional email isn't the right fit. Transactional emails are sent from one sender to one recipient, and they usually can't include any promotional content. But what's considered promotional can vary, so please be mindful of the laws in your area. Now that I've covered what you need to get started, let's log into Mailchimp. To access Mailchimp Transactional, head to Automations and click Transactional Email. If you don't have a transactional account, you'll find options to pick a plan or try the free demo. A demo account isn't made for day-to-day sending, so it does have limitations. You can send up to 500 transactional emails, but you can only send to email addresses on your verified domain. So if my domain is Mailchimp.com, I can send to other people who share that domain, like my coworkers. If you'd like to send to email addresses that aren't on your domain, you'll need to upgrade to a paid plan. I covered those points pretty quickly, so check out our Help Center for more information on demo accounts. Next, click Launch App to use our transactional platform. You'll be prompted to add a sending domain if one isn't already set up. In any case, you'll want to make sure that your domain is verified and authenticated. So, let's head to Settings. After that, click Domains, and then choose Sending Domains. If you haven't added a domain yet, enter your domain name and click Add. Once you've done that, click View Details in the Verified Domain column. Then, enter a valid email address and click Send Verification Email. Your domain can also be verified by setting up a TXT record in your DNS settings. When you get the email, just click on the verification link and you're all set. For the next step, you'll have to authenticate your sending domain. This is required and you won't be able to send until this step is finished. Authentication shows that you're a legitimate sender, which improves your chances of reaching the inbox. And it helps protect your email domain from being spoofed or impersonated. Also, companies like Yahoo and Google have changed their sending requirements. To put it simply, you'll need to update your DKIM records and set up a DMARC policy. I'll cover the DKIM settings column first. Let's click View Details. Then, in the pop-up modal, you'll find instructions on how to create two new CNAME records. This guidance will vary depending on your domain provider, but you can expect to copy values and paste them into your DNS settings. Setting up a DMARC policy is similar to DKIM. So again, the instructions will depend on your domain provider. After you're done setting up DKIM and DMARC, you can click Test DNS Settings to see if everything's working. Keep in mind, it can take some time for DNS records to update. Now that you've authenticated your sending domain, you'll need an API key so that we can communicate with your site or integration. First, let's click the Settings icon to get API keys. Next, click New API Key and give it a description. After that, click Create API Key, and a key will appear in a pop-up modal. Make sure you copy the key and store it in a secure location. Once you close the modal, you won't be able to access or copy the key again. You'll probably want to test some things out before you send actual emails. So you can use Test Mode to refine your integrations for bounce and complaint handling. You can send up to 10,000 test mode messages per day, and this won't affect your monthly email limit or your account's reputation. To use test mode, you'll need to create a test API key, So go to Settings and click Create New API Key. Then choose the checkbox for Test Key and click Create API Key. Finally, don't forget to copy and store your key. Now you can switch to test mode. First, hover over the drop-down arrow near your username, and then choose Turn on Test Mode. With the Test API key, you can manually trigger bounces, rejects, or spam complaints by sending test emails to specific addresses. For example, if you want to test rejects, you'd send a test to reject@test.mandrillapp.com. You can find the other addresses in our developer documentation. There is one more thing I'd like you to note. If you send an email in test mode, you can only access that email in test mode, so you won't find test mode emails on the outbound page. When you're done running some tests, hover over the drop-down arrow by your username and choose Exit Test Mode. So, let's say you've sent out some actual live emails. If you want a quick glimpse of how things are going, click on the dashboard. Here, you'll find stats like monthly sends and deliverability. There's also a graph with sending volume details. If you'd like to filter these stats by date, just use the dropdowns. Now, I want to talk a bit about reputation because it relates to deliverability. Your account's reputation can be poor, good, or excellent. Some factors that determine your reputation are spam complaints, bounces, and unsubscribes, but you can think of it as the amount of failed sends compared to the successful ones. To sum it up, the fewer bounces you have relative to your sending volume, the higher your reputation will be. Your reputation also has a major role in setting your hourly quota, which is the number of emails you can send each hour. Any emails you send over your quota will go to your account's backlog. This is where we hold emails that we can't send immediately, but emails are only stored in the backlog for 48 hours. After that, they'll be deleted from your account entirely. While your hourly quota mainly depends on your sending reputation, we also consider your typical sending volume. The main takeaway here is that a better reputation means you can send more emails that are more likely to reach your contacts. To manage your reputation, it helps to keep track of how well individual emails are being delivered. And you can do that on the outbound page. When an email successfully reaches a contact, its status will be labeled delivered. If an email has bounced, you can click on the bounced status to get more information. Then you can click View Content for the email you want to review. The outbound page is also where you can use your templates. In Mailchimp Transactional, you can create, store, and reuse designs for your messages, so you don't have to start from scratch with every email, which could save you a lot of time. You can set defaults for important data like sender and reply to email addresses, as well as your custom tracking domain. And API calls only need to provide the dynamic parts of your content, which can reduce the amount of data that's passed. Templates also make it easier for non-developers to make changes. And once they finish with their edits, they can easily preview and test templates from within Mailchimp Transactional. There are a few ways to create templates. First, we'll cover how to write HTML directly into the editor. So, from the outbound page, head to Templates and click Create a Template. Then, give your template a name and click Start Coding when you're ready to go. At this point, you can enter your HTML or paste it into the editor. Just make sure you inline your CSS for the best performance. This means including styles within the HTML for specific elements, like a paragraph. When you edit templates, you can personalize your messages with dynamic content. For instance, you could use merge tags or handlebars to pull in names, order information, and other customized content. We don't store any audience information in your transactional account, so all of this data would be passed through an API call. After you've finished coding, you can preview and test your template. And don't forget to either save it as a draft or publish it. If you've created a template in Mailchimp Marketing, you can send it to your transactional account. Just to be clear, Mailchimp Marketing is where you send newsletters and anything promotional. Once you've logged into Mailchimp Marketing, click on Content and then Email Templates. Find the template you want to work with and choose Send to Mandrill in the Edit dropdown. That's it. Now, when you head back to Mailchimp Transactional, your design will appear in templates. Before I wrap up this video, I just want to briefly touch on reports. This is where you'll get some insight on email performance. We track emails on a per-message basis, so opens, clicks, and delivery data are recorded for each email sent through your account. You can click on a location to see interactions by area, and you can review the top email clients and top operating systems. You might notice that some clicks are higher for some clients and operating systems than others, so it could be helpful to test your emails to see if they're displaying correctly. Another thing that's useful on this page is the Compare Stats tab. Here, you can compare different groups of emails based on custom search filters. And with that, I've introduced you to Mailchimp Transactional Email. Thanks for hanging in there. For next steps, check out our developer resources on sending your first transactional email, and stop by our Help Center for more articles and tutorials.